Hello everyone, today our topic is applications of genetically modifications or transgenic plants. So here genetically modifications has made crops more tolerant to abiotic stresses. More tolerant to abiotic stresses. Here, abiotic stresses are cold, drought, salinity, and heat. So these are abiotic stresses. Okay. So here, make crop plants more tolerant to abiotic stresses such as cold, drought, salinity, and heat. So I will give one example for tolerant to abiotic stresses and biotic stresses. So that is the basmati rice variety. The basmati rice variety has both tolerant to abiotic and biotic stresses. So next, another application: reduce reliance on chemical pesticides. Best example nematode resistant tobacco plant. And another example BT cotton. So, and also they help to reduce the post-harvest losses. Reduced post-harvest losses. For example, flavor-saver tomato variety. So another application, so they increase the efficiency of mineral usage by plants. That prevents early exhaust of fertility of soil. Okay, another one, transgenic plants are enhance the nutrients value. Transgenic plants have enhanced in nutrients and value of food materials. Okay, so best example, vitamin A enriched rice variety. So these are the main applications of genetically modified organisms. Okay, what are they? Tolerant to abiotic stresses. Example, basmati rice. Resistant to both abiotic and biotic stresses. And next one, reduce the chemical pesticides. Best example, nematode resistant tobacco plants and BT cotton. They also help to reduce the post-harvest losses. Example, flavor-saver tomato. And another one, increase the efficiency of mineral usage by plants that prevents early exhaust of soil fertility. And last one, they enhance the nutrients value of food materials. Best example, vitamin A enriched rice varieties. Now I am coming to the next point. Some other applications of biotechnology in agriculture. That is discussing about the another applications. Insect resistant plants. In insect resistant plants, most important taxon is BT toxin. So here, BT abbreviated in the form of Bacillus thuringiensis. So BT is the short form of bacteria. BT is the short form of bacteria. So that is Bacillus thuringiensis. This bacteria produces the BT toxin. This bacteria produces BT toxin, that is the endotoxin. That is endotoxin. These endotoxins kills a wide group of insect pests. Kills a wide group of insect pests. Kills a wide group of insect pests. But they are not harmful to man and other domestic animals. Okay. So here toxic genes isolated from bacteria, that is Bacillus thuringiensis. Toxic genes isolated from Bacillus thuringiensis, BT. Here toxic genes isolated from Bacillus thuringiensis. So these genes introduced with the TI plasmid. Introduced with the TI plasmid. This is a one type of vector of Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So here TI plasmid means tumor inducing plasmid isolated from Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So these plasmid and toxic genes, these two genes are intermixed to each other to form a recombinant DNA. Okay, so such type of plasmid vectors transferred into the plant cells. These plant cells develops into the transgenic plants. These transgenic plants resistant to insect pests. These transgenic plants resistant to insect pests. Now I am giving some examples of insect resistance. So the insects are these transgenic plants resistant to insects. Okay, so these are lepidopterans and coleopterans and dipterans. Lepidopterans, coleopterans and dipterans. So here lepidopterans, best example, tobacco budworm and army worm. So lepidopterans are tobacco budworm and army worm. And coleopterans are beetles. Dipterans, flies and mosquitoes. Okay, so here transgenic plants most resistant to lepidopterans, coleopterans and dipterans. So examples for the lepidopterans, tobacco budworm and army worm. Examples for coleopterans, examples beetles. Example for dipterans, flies and mosquitoes. Okay.